being recorded, so deal with it.
Wait, no, we need one.
Right. I think you just matched parts.
I'm not similar to the action.
Just
say
like that.
God,
why
did I do wrong?
What the heck?
Oh,
wait,
just
I'm on camera.
You could have told me that. It'll only take about 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, shoot.
What is that?
Disgusting.
She said, what is that?
Yeah, that's what I said.
What is wrong with you?
I didn't know what
happened. Gentry, have a seat.
It's true. Why yellow?
Why not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
We're on camera. It's okay.
That hurts my heart.
My
door
is open.
Huh? All right. Sweet. So, guys and girls, few items up on the block. Not in any hurry, but I'd like to have this done by Friday this week, if that's all right. Esty, you owe me the quiz. Abby, you owe me the quiz. Liam, who's not here, owes me the quiz. Wyatt, you missed a quiz yesterday. Mr. Stacks, you owe me the quiz. So by Friday, my best times to come in for me would be before school. I'm here by 6:30. First period, I'm off. Third period, I'm off. Fourth period, I'm off. If you wanted to come in during fifth and sixth period, I'm in here. So there's classes that are in here, which is fine. I have no problem putting you over at the side desk. And that's what we got. Sound good? So by Friday, please, would be awesome. Some of you did very well on the quiz, and some of you... you need to go back and you probably should come see me. You didn't do well. You didn't do well for a number of reasons. Because one, you didn't study, you weren't prepared for it. And so, you know, please understand, if you're not studying for stuff, you're not going to do good on it. And no, we don't do retakes. Okay, it's not our policy. If you want retakes, you can go to Eagle Crest. Yeah. I don't know. I think you did. I mean, check your grade when you want. No, I'm not preaching to everybody. I'm preaching to those who aren't doing, you know, you're not doing homework. You're not studying at home. You're not taking, you know, your homework is, oh, I found the answers at the very back of the thing, and I'm just going to put those down because you give me points for it. Yay. Okay? No. You're the person who's copying your homework answers from the back because we've provided the answers that you double check. This is not a seek and find. If that's you, I will tell you high school is going to be a really rough road for you, and you more than likely won't get through the math. If you don't get through the math, you don't graduate. And I'm just telling you. Now again, I'm not speaking to everybody. I'm just speaking to those who think I don't have to do anything and everyone will provide for me. Doesn't work that way. Okay, you're in for a rude awakening. So we're starting a new unit called exponential functions and sequences. Okay, exponential functions deal with when we are raising an exponent. We're raising an exponent as our variable, as a letter. Okay, so those notes that are in front of you should guide you through. Should guide you through. Those of you who sit there and say, "Oh, I don't need to take notes because I don't learn that way," you have an F now. So maybe you try a new way to learn because you have an F. Yeah, it's pretty pathetic that new concepts can't be taught to you because, oh, I don't learn that way. Well, then fail out of school. Okay? That's the long and short of it. Again, I'm not preaching to everybody. I'm preaching to those who I had numerous signals from your parents going, what can they do to improve their grade? Here's the options. Well, what else is available? Well, let's start with these options first. Because they're not being done. And you think I'm kidding? There are some horrific emails I've gotten from parents going, dude, give me a break. All right, we have worked with linear functions. Those are straight lines. Okay, straight lines. We know we have vertical and horizontal ones. We have ones that have positive slopes. We have ones that have negative slopes. Okay, linear functions all look like straight lines. What do their graphs look like? Straight lines. Okay? So determine if the equation represents a linear function or not. So what do you think? Does it look like a linear function? Okay, so let's put this up for those of you who can't remember. Y equals mx plus b would be an example of y equals 3x plus 2. X equals 6 is linear. Y equals 7 is linear. Y equals x is linear. 3x plus 2y is equal to 8 is linear. Does problem number one look like a linear equation?
Yes.
What does problem number one have as part of it?
A square root.
Do any of my linear equation problems have a square root in it? No. So is problem number one a linear function?
No.
Okay. Problem number two, is it linear?
No.
Why not? Number two is?
Oh, no, because it has an exponent.
Got an exponent right there. So this graph actually looks something like this. It curves sideways. It goes like that. This one actually kind of looks like this. Those are definitely not linear. What about number three, linear?
Yes.
Yeah, y-intercept of 1, slope of 1 over 1, totally line. Yes. Problem number four, linear? No, it's got this. So this actually looks, this is called a parabola. It looks like that. Problem number five?
Yes.
We have a fraction, but can we have a fraction as a slope?
Yes.
Could we have a fraction that crosses the y-axis?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this has a y-intercept of 1, and it has a slope of negative 1 over 1. So, yes, this is a linear function. Problem number 6. We have a fraction as a slope. We have a linear. This is linear. So cool. So three of those are linear. So things that don't make linear is when you start dealing with an exponent on a variable or dealing with a square root that has the variable, which is the letter underneath it. Okay? That's what we got. Should we move forward? Mike, go follow the notes okay so far? So exponential functions, the essential question, what do exponential functions look like, and what are some of the characteristics of the graph of an exponential function? We're gonna go apart. So, a few things for you. Exponential functions are come in a lot of different places. Exponential functions are how your cells multiply or how your cells decay off. Okay? You all have growth going on because you're probably getting taller, you know, as you approach being an adult. As you get real old, there are things in your body still aren't developing as an exponential function, but you're more of a on the decay. Your bone mass is in a decaying fashion. Do you know that your body, the reason why we want people, you know, I don't want it, I mean, it's what the medical professionals say, you should drink milk and take be ingesting calcium, because up until age 35, for an average age, your body will absorb more and more calcium. That's where your bones and your teeth. At age 35, your body will absorb no more calcium. Now, you can take calcium supplements to try and maintain where you're at, but up until age 35, you're not going to, you continue to gain more and more calcium that your body absorbs and uses. Makes your bones strong, makes your teeth strong. Okay? For those, I don't take calcium, it's overrated. To tell you that osteoporosis is a huge problem, okay? And breaking bones is not something that's fun. And some of you have unfortunately broken bones. It doesn't mean you have bad calcium. It just means you did a little torque. All right. So y equals a times b, and b happens to be raised to the x. Now a and b will become numbers. Okay, so starting point, y-intercept is a. So So if it's a number, y-intercept is where it crosses the y-axis. And then b is the growth rate. And then x stays the variable. Okay, it stays as a letter. Order of operations would suggest that you do the exponent first and then do the multiplication. Don't multiply first. So if you had a being 3 and b being 6, and 6 was raised to the x power, you can't go 3 times 6 to get 18. Okay, because one of them has an exponent, one of them doesn't. Okay, so starting point is a, b to the x. So depending upon your function, zero comma a, and then it curves up. It grows rapidly. You will all be at a point in life where you are enticed by the credit card. And it seems like a really neat thing. And the credit card draws you in with saying, hey, get, you know, start out with a $500 balance. It means you can spend $500. Once you spend $500, you have to start paying it back. But they'll have it as a way of saying, oh, but your minimum payment on $500 is $12 a month. You're like, dude, sweet. Man, $12 a month? I can spend $500 and only have to pay it back $12 at a time each month? I got that covered. If you pay the minimum balance back on a credit card, especially a first-time credit card, that $500 that you think is a great idea to spend all at once and slowly pay back, if you were to pay back the minimum payment on that, you would wind up paying $7,500 for your $500 adventure. Credit cards are a great tool for life. They can get you in trouble real quick. So please be cautious when you come. And the reason I say credit cards is the money value that a credit card company makes off of first-time users is an exponential growth in their favor. They love having you guys come. Okay? Yes, there are all these commercials saying, hey, what's in your wallet? You get points back, up to 1.5% cash back. Does anybody know what that means? That means for each dollar you spend, you get 1.5% back sent to you each month if you'd like. Or you can spend it as far as points on airlines or this and that. People are like, oh, this is great. Does anybody know what the interest rate is on credit cards? 18% to 24%. Okay? Yes, you can get that lowered as long as you've been a part of that company for a long time. But a first-time user, probably going to have around 24%. So a little something called the rule of 72. How fast does it take to double? Rule of 72 works this way. Okay? You go 72 divided by 24 is roughly 3, which means 3 units of time. It's doubled. That's scary. Okay? So don't get caught in the credit card adventure. It's real easy to. Those rent-a-centers for furniture and TVs and things like that, hey, it also only costs you $7 a week. Dude, I'm in. And that $400 TV winds up costing you about $1,800. Yeah, but it's only $7 a week. It's really helpful for me. Okay? Best economic plan for people. Unfortunately, it's all a con game out there. Okay, we want to fill in the table and see how things work. Okay, what do you notice? Which is linear, which is exponential? Does everyone feel okay that I'm going to label this as exponential and this is linear? Does everybody see why?
Yes.
Okay, first one I'm raising an exponent to x. The second one, I'm going 16 plus 2x. The number values are pretty much the same. So, doing a little bit of work, and you might have to squeeze off to the side. So if I'm going to plug in 0, I get 16 times 2 raised to the 0 power. What is 2 to the 0 power?
1.
So this becomes 16 times 1, which is equal to
16.
16. Everyone good there?
Next one, 16 times 2 raised to the first. What's 2 to the first?
2.
2. 16 times 2 then is?
32.
32. Let's go here. 16 times 2 raised to the third. 2 times 2 times 2 is?
8.
8. And 8 times 16, I don't have a calculator, but help me out, please. If you have a calculator, great. While you guys are getting that out, I'll do the next one. 16 times 2 to the 4th. 16 times 2 to the 5th.
The answer for the 2 is 128.
How much?
128.
128? What? 128. Thank you. This next one, 16 times 2 to the 4th. 2 to the 4th is 2, 4, 8, 16. So 16 times 16 is 256. 2 to the 5th is 32, so I get 16 times 32. Help me out. 512? So are all those correct? I don't have a calculator with me, so please, if you're just shouting out arbitrary values.
There's another one.
Oh, is there one more? Oh, yeah. It's going to go a little bit bigger. 16 times 2. Oh, wait, I went off.
You went off on the three. Two to the third power.
All right, so you know what I'm going to do? This one, 2 to the third is, so we'll just do this. 2 to the third, 2 to the fourth, 2 to the fifth, and then the one that should have been here, I'm going to make that 2 to the second. Is that all right? Okay, so 16 times 4. 16 times 4 is 64. That'll work. So that should have came up there. Sorry about that goof up. That grew up pretty quick?
Yep.
So where something like this might take place? In biology, some of you might be taking biology now. Some might be signed up for next year. Let's talk about a certain bacteria that you're trying to grow in a petri dish. It's going to grow at an exponential rate. And there's, depending upon what types of things you're using, some things have a much shorter lifespan than other things, and some things have a longer lifespan. So let's say you were to take fruit flies. Okay, seems like the favorite for some of us. Okay, so you decide to start out with two fruit flies in their little tank. Those two little fruit flies decide they want to get together and make more fruit flies. And then all those fruit flies decide they want to make more fruit flies. Fruit flies don't recognize brothers and sisters and things like that. It's just how fruit flies work. Okay? They're going to grow rapidly. So you could say, hey, so at the first, at day zero, when we're starting, we might have started out with 16 fruit flies. And then we have 32. And then we have 64, 128, 256, 512. 512 fruit flies on the fifth day. Is that a lot of fruit flies? Yeah. Could that ruin a harvest? Yeah, because they're going to continue to grow more and more and more. What do we do to try and combat these? We use chemical warfare. And we think this is a good idea. And then they say, oh, if you just rinse this under cool water, it'll rinse off anything bad that's on your fruits and vegetables. Oh, okay. It's somewhat sarcastic. Sorry about that if any of you are offended by it, but think about that. So the tap water coming out of our faucet should rinse off anything bad that is on the fruits and vegetables that we're ingesting that are used, and we use the pesticides on those fruits and vegetables to combat insects. Yeah, we're all in the alarm. Oh, but it's organic, so it's good for you. Good. Organic means it's carbon-based. Okay? We're all organic. This desk is organic. It's made of carbon. Should I eat my desk? Yeah, it's organic. It's natural. It's healthy. You find these in nature everywhere. Don't fall under the whole scam of the organic. It's like, no, but this is what this really means. This. Okay there, rock star.
You ever been over to Whole Foods?
Yes.
Go into Whole Foods. Go over to the King Supers or the Safeway or something and find the Red and Delicious apples. You probably get a big 5-pound bag for $1.50 or something at the King Supers. Go over to Whole Foods. Same exact bag. Same exact orchard. $8. Oh, but ours are organic. No, they're not. They came off the right, same truck. They came out of the same field. I feel good about Whole Foods. No, it's natural. Right. You're absolutely right. It's natural. Okay. Let's talk about linear. We're going to do the exact same thing. 16 plus 2 times 0. That's 16 plus 0 equals 16. Hey, look at here. We're at the same, yes?
So what's the big deal?
Okay, we'll see. 16 plus 2 times 1. That's 16 plus 2, which is 18. Are we a little further apart? Okay, now I goofed up, so I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to make that third, fourth, this one down here would be fifth, just so we can see. Fifth, and then we made this one second, right?
Yeah.
All right, so 16 plus 2 to the third. 16 plus 6 is 22. How far apart are we?
Not much.
16 times 2, or what? Oops, sorry. Plus 2 times 4. 16 plus 8. 24. 10 times bigger there. 16 plus 2 times 5. 16 plus 10. 26. Oh, let's go back and do the 2. 16 plus 2 times 2. So that would have been 16 plus 4, which is 20. So again, this should have come up in here. So 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26. 16 from here to here is 16 more. From here to here, a lot more than 16. Notice my difference that's taking place here is each time we are increasing by 2. Here, this increased by 16. Here, 128 minus 32 is how much? Or actually, 32. So that 32 actually went to there. So that goes up 32. And then from here back to here, that's up 64. And then that's up. It's just going like crazy. Think about it. Think about what this means. If you had started with two little things, if it grows at linear, the next day you have this. And then the next day you have this. And then the next day you have this. And then the next day you have this. That's a nice linear scenario. You started with the exponential. You started out with these two. And then it goes to these two. Wait, I didn't even get done. There's still more. Which one grows faster? Exponential. That right there is so many things. Moving on. Core concept, graphing. When y equals a times b raised to the x, when b is greater than 1, so b is 1.0001 all the way up to infinity, and then when b is greater than 1, so right here, look at this. A is greater than 1. It's going whoop, straight up.
when your b value is a fraction. So this right here, that's when this is taking place. Or this when this is taking place. Actually, no, I'll take it back. So when your b value is a fraction, okay? They have this kind of goofy how they have it set up. I don't know why we have this graph here, so I'm just going to cross that off right now. So growth, decay. Growth, decay. What are some things that go with decay? Well, we're in mid-February right now, a little bit beyond mid-February, more, a little more than halfway through. And we've seen a lot of kids who are absent. And kids are coming back and they got colds, and strep, and all these other fun, magical things that you as kids get. But don't worry, it builds your immunity for later in life. Yeah. Why don't adults get as sick as kids? Yeah, we've had those silly things that you guys have had. Does that mean that adults don't get colds and the flu and stuff like that? No, they will. They absolutely will. But we've been exposed to more of them, so our bodies have built the identities. Now, immunology works. Okay? So, what types of things out there work? Well, those of you who've gotten sick with, say, strep, you probably went to the doctor and you got some sort of cillin as the end of the word. It could have been penicillin, it could have been amoxicillin. There's other cillins that are out there as well. Okay, what do? They destroy bacteria. Okay, here's the tough thing with taking any of those cillins. Amoxicillin and penicillin, they don't know good bacteria from bad bacteria. So they just kill all the bacteria in your body, which seems like a pretty good idea. I don't even know what bacteria is. No, you need to survive with bacteria, especially in your GI tract. That's your, all the way from your mouth all the way to where it comes out the backside. Okay? You have bacteria. You need it. Okay? People stop taking amoxicillin and penicillins about 4 or 5 days in, even though it's a 10-day supply. Why is that? Well, I feel better. Good for you. Creating bigger, badder strains of what you had. Best thing to do if you are on any of those cillins, make sure you increase your yogurt intake. I don't like yogurt. Cram it down. You won't have an upset stomach from it. You're replacing the good bacteria that's in your system that you need. There's your medical for today. All right, so which one represents linear and which one? So let's take a look. I go in my x direction 0, 1, 2, 3. In my x direction 0, 1, 2, 3. Those are both the same. So my x isn't going to dictate whether it's linear or not. Agreed? But my y's, I increase by 2. I increase by 2. I increase by 2. Okay, does that mean all linear increases by 2? No, it means it increases by a constant rate. Okay, this has exponential. Well, grew by 4, grew by 8, grew by 16. Linear, exponential. See the difference? One's going to grow at a different rate than the other. If something's growing at a different rate from point to point to point, it's not linear. Why is that? Because the rate, which is called the slope, is the same pitch, no matter where you are on it. Okay? So, let's think about the domain. Well, the domain had to deal with the x values, right? So, let's think about this. If I had a graph that looked like this, or this, or this, or this, or what's my last color? Purple. Or this. That arrow is going forever to the left and going forever to the right. What do
What's the domain then? The domain goes forever to the left, which is negative infinity. Forever to the right is positive infinity. Okay, exponential functions have a domain that's everything. Means you can plug numbers in. Could I have a negative exponent? Yeah, if you have like a number to a negative exponent, it means it needs to move to its location. If you had 5 to the negative 2 power, that means it's got to become 1 over 5 to the second. It's no longer a negative exponent because it moved down. It becomes 1 over 25. The range. We haven't really talked a whole lot about range. One thing about range is being an elevator. Okay? Let's say we had this exponential function. And I'm just going to give you one example. The exponential function, the range is dictated by this. So if you have nothing there, your range is 0 to infinity. If it's going down, it's 0 to negative infinity, depending upon the graph. So let's say I had y equals abx plus 10. That means this whole line here shifts up to 10 and it won't cross it. So your range is whatever's here. I'm not going to go too much more into the detail. It'll make a little bit more sense as we do some more problems. But our range deals from wherever our graph appears to be approaching closer and closer and closer, but never crosses. All right. So let's graph y equals our function at x, which is the same thing as y equals 2 to the x. Let's graph it. See if we can figure this out. We'll do this one in blue. So I have my x and y value. Let's go negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Does that seem okay to plug in? Well, let's see if we can walk through this. 2 to the negative 2 is the same thing as 1 over 2 to the second, which is 1 over 2 to the second. 2 to the second is 4, isn't it? So negative 2, 1 fourth. About there. Let's plug negative 1 in. 2 to the negative 1 is 2 to the negative 1, which is 1 over 2, which is half. So at negative 1, I'm at half. Plug 0 in. What's 2 to the 0? 1. Good. 1. 2 to the first is 2. Two to the second, 2 squared, 4. Heck, we could even plug a 3 in there. What's 2 to the third? 2 times 2 times 2.
8.
8, right? Grows exponentially. Okay. The domain of the blue. Could I keep plugging negative numbers in this way? So if I plug negative 3 in, I'd get 2 to the negative 3, which is 1 over 2 to the third, which 2 to the third is 8, so 1 over 8. If I plug negative 4 in, I get 1 over 2 to the, or 2 to the negative 4 is 1 over 2 to the 4, which is 1 over 16. If I plug negative 5 in, I get 1 over 32, 1 over 64, 1 over 128, 1 over 256, 1 over 512. Those fractions are getting really close to the x-axis. Okay? So the domain of the blue is going to go from negative infinity to positive infinity. The range appears that it's coming really close to 0. It's not ever going to get there. So I need a rounded bracket. So it's starting here. Okay, it's never going to get there, and it's going to go up for the range. So it's going to go to infinity. Remember, the domain is the x component. The range is the y component.
Okay, so let's do this one. We'll do this one in green. So that's y is equal to 4 times 2 to the x. Okay? We'll just expand it over here, see what we can do. 4 times 2 to the x. So we're going to still use our same x value, negative 2. So if I plug negative 2 in here, I get 2 to the negative 2, which is 1 over 2 to the second, which is 1 fourth. 4 times 1 fourth is? 4 times 1 fourth is? 1. Okay. If I plug negative 1 in, 2 to the negative 1 is the same thing as half. What's half of 4?
2.
Okay, plug 0 in. 2 to the 0 power is? 1. 1 times 4 is?
4.
Plug 2 in. 2 squared is? 4. 4 times 4 is? 16.
Wouldn't it be just
2
to the
1?
It's not 2 squared.
2 to the 1st. Oh, yeah. 2 to the 1st. Yeah, you got it. You're going to get ahead of yourself on this. All right, so 2, we're here. Plugging 1 in. 2 to the 1st is 2, right? Times 4 is 8. Wait, wrong color. All right, let's plug 4 in, 2 to the 4th. Or wait, plug 2 in, I'm sorry. Plug 2 in. 2 squared is 4. 4 times 4 is 16. Let's plug 3 in, 2 to the 3rd. 2 times 2 times 2. 8. 8 times 4 is 32. Okay? So I can plot this, negative 2 comma 1. Negative 2 comma 1, it's above it. Negative 1 comma 2. 0, 4. Did I do that right? Negative 1. Oh, this one's off. Can't count these days, I tell you. Negative 1, 2 is here. Now we're right. All right, 0, 4. 1, 8. I can't really use anymore, can I? It's going to be off the screen. What's this one doing? So what do you think the domain would be on the green? I keep plugging any number in, negative, positive, zero. So the domain of the green is negative to positive infinity. The range of the green, does it look like it's starting about the same spot? It's growing at a different rate, but it's starting there. So it's going to go from 0 to infinity. It starts from the x-axis and moves up.
Wait, is it possible for any sort of graph to move vertically straight up without a slope?
Yeah, it's called a vertical line, an undefined line. Oh. None of these, though they're looking like they're starting to go straight up, they will never get to vertical. They're approaching it, though, but they won't get there. All right, let's see in here. Oh, wait. What's the difference between these two graphs? The green one's growing a little bit faster than the blue one. That's it. Okay? Okay, so let's same thing. Y equals 1 half to the x, and the other one is negative 1 half to the x. So let's see what's going to happen here. Let's plug some values in. So we'll do this one in blue. Okay, we'll call that y is equal to that. All right, so let's plug, let's see, let's go negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. That should be enough. Okay, ready? If I plug negative 2 in here, I get 1 half to the negative 2. The whole quantity is to the negative 1 half. What does 1 half do?
Oh, it flips.
It flips. So this becomes 2 to the second. 2 to the second is? Okay, ready? This is all I did.
But why did you flip it?
Because we multiply with a fraction.
A negative exponent tells these guys to switch locations so it flips the whole fraction.
So always flip it if it's a negative. Uh-huh.
But wouldn't the whole fraction go down? Wouldn't it go under?
So this means, hang on, hang on, hang on. This means, let me do this.
This means that comes here and here. So that's 1 to the negative 2 and 2 to the negative 2. They want to switch spots, so it becomes 2 to the second over 1 to the second, which is 4 over 1, which is 4. Can I erase that? That's the math that's taking place, okay, which is the whole last chapter, which some of you discovered the answers in the very back, saying, sweet, I got all my points on the homework, so I'm going to tell mommy and daddy I got all my points on homework because I did my work. No, you didn't. You plagiarized it. Okay, so if 1/2 to the negative 2 flips the whole thing over and squares it, what is 1/2 raised to the negative 1? 2 over 1, right? Which is 2? If I plug 0 in, 1/2 to the 0 is 1, good. 1/2 to the first power? 1/2. 1/2 to the second power. 1/2 times 1/2 is? 1/4. Okay. So let's do the same thing. Negative 2, 4. Okay. Negative 1, 2. 0, 1. 1/2. 2, 4.
1/2 times 1/2
is 1/4. 1/2, 1 times 1 is 1. Good job, though.
Oh.
Right. What does this domain look like? It's going from negative infinity to positive infinity. The range is going to zero, but where'd it come from? Way up here. What's way up here?
Infinity.
There you go. Let's try this negative half, though. We'll do this one in red. Okay? So we're going to worry about those values here. Plug in those Rx components. Okay, 1/2 raised to the negative 2, flip the whole thing over to become 1/4, but I have a negative out front, so I get negative, right? This one, if I plug that in, it flips the whole fraction over, so 1/2 to the negative 1 becomes 2, that negative here makes it negative 2. Anyone seen a pattern? Okay, see what this does. Negative 2, negative 2, negative 4, negative 1, 2, 0, negative 1, 1/2, 4. What's this one doing?
Starting down from negative.
Yeah, so my domain, I can plug in any value still. My domain's negative to positive infinity. My range, it's coming from where?
Negative
infinity. It's approaching what?
Zero.
Done. Cool. We all right so far? This is new stuff. I'll get you through it. But if you go to the back of the homework to find the answer saying, oh, look what I did, you cheated! What do you mean? What's the difference between the two graphs? One's, they're flipped over of the x-axis is what happened because of the negative. All right, so let's graph this. Any takers on what's going to take place? It's not going to approach this line any longer. What do you think it's going to approach?
The up and down one.
It's going to approach this 3. Here we go. So that should be all right. So let's make that like a greenish. 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Just a smidge.
Okay, what is this graph doing? This. Domain appears to be what?
Negative
to positive infinity. Range?
3.
Good. It's never going to cross it to?
Infinity.
There you go. So if I add or subtract, if I add something, that becomes, that changes the range. If I subtract something, it's down here. It changes the range. Changes the asymptote that you cannot cross. The asymptote you can't cross is that dark green line.
So the domain will always be negative.
As far as these go, yes. Negative and positive infinity. The range is what's going to get modified. Okay? Let's see. This graph represents a bacterial population y after x days. Write an exponential function that explains the population. Okay? So at 0, it was at 3. So remember, we have y equals ab raised to the x. We talked back here, very first slide. Where's that? Starting point is our a value. Our a value. Our starting points are a value. Y equals 3 times something to the x power. My growth rate, how often is it doubling? Or what is it doing? From day 1, we started with 3. Or, you know, when we first got to the lab, there's 3. After a day, it goes to 12. After that, it continues. 48, 192, 768. By 4. So tentatively, we have this. Are we right? How can we figure this out? Let's do this. X, Y, 0, 1, 2. That should be enough. If I were to plug 0 into that equation, 4 to the 0 is 1. 1 times, got 3. Good, that works. Plug 1 in to our equation. 4 to the first is 4. 4 times 3 is? Gonna work. Plug 2 in. 2 squared, or 4 squared, 16 times 3 is 48. There's our equation. That's our equation right there.
Sweet.
New stuff. Brand new stuff. Okay, I will try and clarify it the best I can, but guys and girls, I'm gonna tell you this. If you are the person who is going to the very back and copying the answers, going, ah, look what I found, I'm so smart. No, you're not smart. Okay? You're going to fail this class. Okay? Your worksheet is page 25, 26. Okay? Page 25, 26. Do it, try it. My notes are online, my videos are online.
This is really
useful. Oh, thanks, buddy.
And then I'll come fourth or junior
office. Yeah, fourth, or are you off any other periods later?
Eighth, and then I go home.
Eighth, okay.
So I'll be here fourth.
It's CP geometry.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, so